Radio number 6, baby! Hello, I'm back at the bus. Oh, I'll show where I'm at.
So yeah, okay, I've masked all the sides, all this nice trim. Put a bit of filler on, didn't need to, but a couple of the nails went in a bit deep. So I've done all that all around that one, the two back ones, and the bathroom one, basically the only windows that are in. So, and I thought, basically what I thought was, I'm about to paint all these black, and originally I was gonna leave this bottom bit here. None of this, look, it's all crap, and it's like, it goes from really nice to really bad, and I thought, do you know what, I'll do this next year, no dramas. Like, replace all this, all new trim, and sort out this waviness. But then I thought, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to quickly take these two lights off, just give it a quick wire brush over and sand, take these off, and I'm just going to stick a new number plate on, maybe, and just give it a coat of yellow, and then give the bumper a coat of black. Seeing as I have black and yellow on hand, and I'm not going to do any filling or anything major, but just touch it up, just so it looks good until, you know, when I do it next year. So while the wood filler's drying on here, I'm just gonna rip, just get everything off of here and sand it down, paint it yellow, and then when I get paint this black, paint the bumper black at all, and it will just complete the back, really, make it all look really fresh. So let's sort this bottom bit out. I might have forgot to turn the camera on, and I've just finished painting it. So coat number three done. I've got some more pallet wood. My theory is that if I do it every now and again, just in small amounts, it doesn't seem as much in one lump sum hit. So got another boot full of pallet. Got to denail it all, stock it up, and leave it for later. This could take a while, so I'll come back to you when I've done it. Woo! All done. So I've got a couple more here. So that's much better if you do it steady and slowly over a long period of time, otherwise. But that got boring pretty quickly. Sorry? Yeah. Working on living the dream. Yeah, it's coming along. All right, can I do this? Can I pick these up at once? Oh, piece of cake, mate. I did so much without remembering to film today. But anyway, all painted and all siliconed in. So the whole lot is now siliconed and weatherproof. So basically from there to there, it's done. I've just got to put a bit of silicone around the grill. And then all this is painted in, put the rubber thing back on when it's dry. Painted the bottom of the bumper. Looks really nice now. I mean, there's cracks in it and that, but as I said, it's just to make it look better. So yeah, it looks a lot better down here. Once I get a new number plate put on and some new number plate lights and the thing, so that'll be really good once that's done. Same with this. There we go, all in, weather sealed, finished. Finished, three windows actually finished. I'm psyched about that. Oh yeah, look, I bought loads of insulation. So there's like 30 mil, there's 25 mil, there's 40 mil, all there. I don't even want to tell you how much that cost. So yes, I won't end it here. It's a bit of a rubbish video really. So I think I'll just sort of continue it through the week. So I'll see you on whatever day I come back. All right, so it's Monday. Oh, yep. So it's Monday, horrible day. Not really much to be doing at work. It's raining, so that limited me a lot. I should really stay at work, but then that's the whole point of this bus, is that I want to have a life where I feel like I'm not pressured to go to work every day. And even through the build, I don't want to feel like that. So I was like, forget it, take Monday off. So here I am. I've got some really cool stuff to do today as well. I picked up the small kitchen thin window, which looks mental now. And then I've got to do loads of Sellotexing in there, which is going to make it look really close to being finished. Yes, I'm going to put this, try and take maybe take out some holes for the speakers. That's exciting. So yeah, loads to do.
But just as I was teletexting, I remembered I've got to put these fencing down this side. That'd be nice in there like that. This one, just down here like that, like in between. Not parallel, not anything, just hidden away in a nice little gap there. So, yeah.
Give the end bits of the wood some undercoat. Thick daub of any sort of adhesive, really. I just happen to have silicone to hand. And I've got this like mesh stuff, push it into the silicone. Well, basically what this does is just stops any creepy crawlies, bugs, and you know, anything getting in, because anything that will try and get in here and make a little nest somewhere, you know, nice. So this lets the air flow, but stops any wildlife trying to live in my bus with me.
All right, great, here we go, done. So we got one there, back to the light, and don't worry about all the dust, but yeah, another one there. And then there'll be two fridge ones going, an inlet and an outlet up here. So I'll integrate that into the whole flowing of the cavity system. But yeah, one there, pretty remote. I quite like where they're placed. Yeah, happy with that. And now the insides are done, so now I can finally start teletexting. But first, I think I'm gonna put this window in so that I can just teletex that whole wall. You should see it. It's like a letter, no, I'll show you. Here's the glass. It's ridiculous, isn't it? Literally just fits my eyes. So, anyway, I'll show you the shaft, the frame. Here's the frame. Look at it. I thought it was cool. Because it's an eye height. Love it. I got the sill on there. There we go. So, right, let's have a look what she looks like. She'll go in. Oh, look at that. Beautiful. Alright, I've got the glass in. It's a nightmare clicking in those beads on the front. For now, I've just got to put this sort of rubber on the inside. Rubber beading that holds the glass in, and yeah, just more weather tight, obviously. Right, chuckle this in. Look at it. Brilliant. So the reason I wanted it this size was because I didn't want a massive window here. I want to have an epic, this is where the kitchen's going, so I want to have like some epic splashback with all like wooden knife holders and chopping board holders. And then I wanted to have a little garden under here as well. I put loads like little tray underneath this window and just have loads of bonsai trees. I thought that'd be banging, like, and then loads of plants around the top. I wanted to all this be like a bit jungly around here, and then all these cool little utensil things. So that's the reason for that small window. And it's just really different as well, you know. So sick. So then all I've got is this one, but I can't afford this one yet. Next week, I'll be able to afford that one and get that in there. And there it is, up there. So, yeah, a bit different, isn't it? All right, so I'm laying the insulation now, and I'm gonna lay a lot of the wires in the insulation. So one thing I've got to get up here is the getting a hole in the roof for the solar panel wires to go down. I'm not going to get solar for a long time, but it just means that once I've done the hole and I've read the wires, I'm not going to have this problem about where to put the wires when I if I do it later. So I do it now, put the wires in, leave it, and I can install it whenever I'm ready. So you basically drill a hole there, put some silicone around here, and there we go. You feed the wires through there, down the hole. It's all good. I've got to put a grommet on the hole, and I've got to clean all this area, because otherwise the silicone won't stick. Oh my god, I had no idea my roof was this yellow. Look at that. Oh my god, that's amazing. Oh my god! Well, that is a dirty roof. Alright, so I've got the two solar panelled wires, and this box obviously for streamlined sits like that. So I'm gonna, doesn't really matter which is which now, they're not left or right yet. They're just wires. So I chuck that in there. There we go, tighten that up. I will put a grommet here. Nice thick bead around here. All right, I just put the counter there to keep it around, because it's silicone, it'll start sliding around. So leave that, and I can put that in the wall and just forget about solar until I can afford it in the long, long future. Let's start placing some Celotex. I'll be your lone dancer, you know it, baby. got the black lung, pa.
Alright, so I'll end it here. I'm just going to carry on sellotexting through the week, and then hopefully next weekend the door and frame's coming, so I'm going to put that in. Thanks for watching the sixth video now of my bus conversion, and there'll be plenty more to come.
I'll tell you what, that's the way to do it. Everyone always complains about Monday, me being one of them, but we do nothing about it. So if you don't like Monday, change it. I made Monday my bitch today. I love Monday now. I can't wait for Monday to come at me next week. I will smash it out the park. Here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Then that time I went and said goodbye. Now I'm back and not ashamed.